Friends, today RBI has issued the much awaited notification for grade BDR recruitment, and I've gone through the recruitment advertisement and I did not find major changes in the syllabus and all these things. So I'm uploading this video related to the preparation strategy. Since we have limited time, so I'm just uploading for economic and social issues so that you can prepare accordingly. In a day or two, I'll upload the preparation strategy for the English paper and for finance and management paper. So first, for the phase one preparation, the phase one is for screening purpose only, because there will be around 500,000 people will be appearing for the exam. So to screen out these candidates and to find out the deserving candidates, the phase one exam is conducted, and the marks obtained in phase one are not considered for the final selection or final declaration of the merit. This paper will be completed in 120 minutes and will be conducted on August 16, 2018. And this will contain four sections: general awareness, English language, quantitative aptitude, and reasoning. So for general awareness, I'll suggest that since the last 6 months general current affair is sufficient, but for the separate side, I'll suggest that you should prepare from January 2018 onwards. And you may also see my videos on current affairs, and you should also read current affairs from various other websites. And one more thing which I'll suggest you, that you should go to RBI website, and there will you will find a link on FAQs. So you should read all the FAQs thoroughly, because generally you will be finding some questions pertaining to directly picked up from these FAQs. So they are very handy, they will be very helpful for you in general awareness for phase one, as well as in certain section of phase two also. And then English language, since we have a limited time, so our strategy should be very strict. So I'll suggest that you should buy this general English by Lucent, and in that they have given certain in the first 3-4 chapters they have given some English grammar rules. So you should go through all those English grammar rules so that you can be sure that you'll be doing all the English grammar questions perfectly, and there should not be any negative question, wrong question in English grammar. And the English comprehension, which requires a long strategy, if you have been preparing for this exam for a long time, you'll be able to do this English comprehension part also. So at this point of time, I will not suggest you that you should memorize some English meanings and all these things. I'll just simply say that you should focus more on English grammar. And then for quantitative aptitude, I'll suggest that you buy this Quaker Maths by M. Tyra. And in that book, you will find very good fast tricks, quick tricks for mathematics. And then for reasoning, I'll suggest that you buy Verbal and Nonverbal Reasoning by R.S. Agarwal. This book is also very helpful for your paper. And thereafter, once you have gone through these books, then you should start an online test series. There will be a numerous online test series available on internet free of cost. You do not need to subscribe any you do not need to pay for any mock test. You should appear for mock test from different websites, because if you are appearing from one website, then they will be having a limited knowledge, their questions will be repeated. So you should appear for online examination, online mock test from different websites. They will be providing free of cost, so it will not be a difficult task. So I'll suggest that you should start from my, I think that you must have started. But if you have not started, nevertheless, you should start from as soon as possible so that you can cover it in well in advance. Now we'll talk about phase two examination. Phase two examination, this is the main exam. Marks obtained in phase two will be considered for the calculation of the merit list. And this phase two will consist of three papers: paper one, economic and social issues; paper two, English writing skills, and paper 3 finance and management. Paper 1 and 3 will be objective type questions, and questions in these papers will be in Hindi and English both, whereas in questions in paper 2 will be in English only, because it is of English language. So here you will have to write the questions by with the help of keyboard and computer system. They will not be giving you any kind of paper, pen, all these things. So entire examination will be on computer set only. Now how you should prepare for the economic and social issues. These are the topics which the RBI has given in its recruitment advertisement. In its syllabus they have given these topics. So I'll suggest that you buy 3 books for economic and social issues. These will also be helpful for finance and management also. So first book is Indian Economy by Mishra and Puri, and second is Introductory Macroeconomics of NCERT Class 12th. This book is also available in e-copy format. I have also given the subscription. I've given the link of the e-book in description box. You can download the book from this description box. And then there is another book that is Fundamental of Human Geography. That is also NCERT book. That will also be helpful. So against each topic I have given the chapter number, so that it will be very easier for you to go through these topics very easily. And I will suggest that you should not confine yourself limited to these readings only. If you are not thorough about the topic, you should go to the internet, you should read thoroughly about the topic, you should be very perfect about the topic. Instead of running here and there and buying number of books, number of study material from different kind of coaching centers, they will not be of any use. You should buy these books, and if the topic is not clear to you, you should go to internet, you should search about the topic, you should read as much as possible, you should discuss with your friends, with your professor, with your colleagues, and try to find out the easiest method of those topics. Because since the exam is MCQ pattern, so you should be well versed about all the basic concepts, all the different terminologies of the topics. So for the primary understanding, for the primary reading, for I have given these suggested list of the topics. From that you can buy, you can read. Say for example, growth and development, you should read the chapter 1 of Mishra and Puri. And for the measurement of growth, national income and per capita income, you should read chapter 14 and 16 of Mishra and Puri. And also you should read chapter 2 of Introductory Macroeconomics of NCERT Class 12th. And you can also watch my videos on these topics. And I'll be uploading videos on all the other topics also. I have uploaded videos on 2-3 topics. And on the economic and social issues, I'll be uploading other topic videos also, so that you can watch these two videos while traveling, while watching, while doing other activities. So these are the chapters you should read. You can pause the videos, you can read in the books. So almost all the topics are covered in these three books, except 2-3 topics which you can read from the internet. Because for these 2-3 topics, buying a separate book will not be any helpful. Because like the topic in Indian political system, you should know what is the democracy, what is the Indian political system, what is the Indian party system, what are the functions of Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, and all these things that you should be knowing about. I think most of us have read these topics during our school days, and generally questions in these topics are very easy. So if you are generally aware, if you are reading the newspapers, it will not be very difficult for you to answer. And the social justice topic that I will also say that you should read from the internet, that you will be reading different and latest topics. So this will also be helpful. And very soon I'll be uploading, in a day or two, I'll be uploading the strategy for the finance and management. That video you can also watch. That will also be very helpful for you. And I'll suggest that while preparing for the phase 1 exam, you should also make a timetable, and you should also read at least 2-3 topics of phase 2 exam also. so that by the time you will be completing, you will be appearing for phase 1 exam, you have completed almost all your phase 2 exam topics also. So after appearing for the phase 1 exam, you can start for your phase 2 exam revision. So that's all for the video. Thanks for watching.